Well, good morning, church. Good to have the kids back. Amen. Hey, I've got a card here. It says, thank you. To the Mercer congregation, our family would like to thank you for your prayers, thoughts, foods, and financial support during the difficult time in our lives. May God bless you from the Keith Blackburn family. Amen. Also tonight, there's no night service. We're actually going to join up with Cloverport Baptist Church at 5 o'clock. They're going to have a sing-in and have an ice cream social. Lauren asked if you want to help sing. If you want to sing during this tonight, just call her, let her know. And she's asking you to be there about 30 minutes early, so that would be about 4:30. But tonight, no church here, but we're going to meet at Cloverport at 5 o'clock, so we'll just go hang out as a community down there. Amen? Also, too, this Friday, the senior adults will be doing a trip. I'm not sure if we've decided exactly where we're going to go eat, but you know that we always go somewhere good, amen? So this Friday, I think we're going to meet at 10 o'clock this Friday, because some of the places that we're talking about, it's going to take a little bit longer to get there. And so if you're free, you don't have to be a senior adult. If you're free Friday, you want to come eat and hang out with us all afternoon, we're going to be leaving here at 10 o'clock on Friday morning, amen? And we're going to hear, yes, ma'am, homecoming? Okay.
Love on our senior adults.
Okay.
I have fun this next Sunday.
Great.
But please keep that day up, October 10th, Tuesday night, our senior adults.
So October 10th, Tuesday night, we'll have a senior adult dinner. Thank you. And then homecoming, we have homecoming flyers that are out now. Be inviting people to come to that as well. We're going to hear from the kids later on. But it's good to have you kids. Did you have fun?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
The adults look a bit weary. Did you keep them up all night?
Yeah,
he's like, You tried your best? Well, hey, let's go to the Lord in prayer, and then we're going to sing some songs, and then we're going to turn it over to you guys and see what you have to do, okay? But let's go to the Lord first in prayer. Yes, ma'am. Oh, yes. Yes, please. I forgot.
Operation Christmas Time. This year we have the old boxes.
So November 12th, make sure you have your boxes, and we'll have a packing party and a prayer party as well that night. So grab a box on your way out and fill it up. Amen? Great ministry. Well, hey, let's go to the Lord in prayer, okay? Most gracious Heavenly Father, today we say thank you for your love for us. And God, we're so thankful that we're in your family and we're your children. God, thank you so much that the kids had fun, it sounds like, this week. And Lord, thank you for working in their lives, and we can't wait to hear about everything that happened to them this weekend. And God, we just say thank you. I know the faith walk is happening even right now, so we pray for our dear sweet sisters that are going through that. We just pray that you continue to move mightily among them. God, today we just want to say thank you for our salvation. Thank you for loving us. I pray that today, if there's somebody in this room that doesn't know you as our Lord and personal Savior, if they're not filled with the Holy Spirit, if they're not saved today, I pray at the end of this, they would have that reassurance. Lord, that they would put all their trust in you and what you've accomplished on the cross. And Lord, they can feel forgiven. They can know that they're forgiven. And they can walk in that freedom and that fullness and that joy. So Lord, we say thank you for loving us today. And you just be glorified in all of this day. Thank you, Father. We pray this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, church. Amen. Brother David.
Did y'all hear what one of them said? I don't even know which one it was. Said they did their best. Amen. That's what we need to do, folks, right? Do our best to keep each other up. Amen, buddy? All right. One of my favorite verses over the years has been, I know whom I have believed, and am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. That takes a lot of pressure off of me, because you see, I'm not good. I didn't have any luck at being good, and I can't keep what I've committed to him. But he has promised that he will keep that and hold that unto that day I stand before him. There's also a song which happened to be one of my heroes' favorite song, Mr. Sonny Foote, I Know Whom I Have Believed. Hymn number 337, if you'll take your hymnal and turn with me, the words will be on the screen too. Let's sing it together this morning. Number 329, if you're using your hymnal this morning.
Sin and I.
Thankful for that grace. That grace he pours out on us every day. Scripture says his mercies are new every day. Thank God. Hallelujah. Thank God. The scripture also says that before the foundations of the world, he knew you, Jacob. He knew you, Colin. He knew David before he ever laid the foundation of the world. That amazes me. And I can come to him and say, Father, it's David. Amen.
Before even time began, promise that he hears us when we call. And here's the thing. He's waiting on us to call on him. Amen? Amen. If you would be seated as the ushers come forward this morning.
Brother Joe, would you lead us in prayer, please?
Most gracious Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the opportunity you've given us today to be in your house. Father, I pray we come here for no other reason than to worship you and lift your name up, Father. I pray we come expecting to see things happen.
Yeah.
Father, as these kids bring their testimony this morning, Father, I pray that you would be with them, Father. I pray they had a great time over the weekend, Father. Thank you for the ones that took them, Father. Took their time to take them, Father. Pray to see the plan. Father, pray for the ones that are sick. Need your healing hand. Father, I pray for our pastor, Father. I pray that you'll stand him up before us and pour him out on us, Father, and just teach us something here today we can use in our everyday life. We're one of the lost souls. So today, Father, be with the ones that are not here today. Be with the ones that travel. Give them traveling mercies, Father. Father, again, I lift up the sick, Father, the ones. They need your healing hand, Father, and I pray that you just bless them and give back to much more to help them. We take up this offering. I just pray that you bless the gift and the giver. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. I missed y'all last week, but I was right where I needed to be. It's one of my blessings in life to be able to serve with men and walk with men through Faith Walk Weekend. Ladies, I know we're your heroes. We're strong. We're supposed to be able to do everything and get it all right and be the man. But you need to know something. We struggle. And we're broken. And the world is lying to us every day. And we lie to ourselves. And we hide it. We act strong because that's what we're supposed to do. And a lot of times that leads us into storms. Storms of our own making, most of the time. Praise God, He never leaves us. I was sure by now, God, you would have reached down and wiped our tears away. Stepped in and saved the day. But once again I say amen, and it's still raining. And as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I raise my hands. Praise a God who gives and takes away. And I'll praise you in this storm, and I will lift my hands. For you are who you are, no matter where I am. And every tear I cry, you hold in your hands. You never left my side. Almost gone. How can I carry on if I can't find you? And as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away. I'll praise you in this storm, and I will lift my hands. For you are who you are, no matter where I am. And every tear I cry, you hold in your hand. You never left my side. And though my heart is my eyes into the hills, where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Now praise you in this storm, and I will lift my hands. For you are who you are, no matter where I am. And every tear I cry, you hold in your hand. You never left.
You know, I was thinking about that song, and then I was thinking about testimony, and you guys are going to testify. You know, God's done amazing things in our lives, hasn't he? Amen. Right? And it's our honor and our privilege to testify, to tell somebody about those stories, because those experiences are real to us, and those experiences can really declare God's goodness in our own personal lives and be an encouragement to other people. So I'm going to pray for you.
Okay.
Amen. You need it? Today? Are you awake?
Yeah, I'm awake.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I don't know how long this is going to take, but we just want you to share and the kids to share about what God has done for you guys this week. Can we pray for these kids? Father, we just want to say thank you for the children. Blessed are the children, God. And I say thank you for being a part of a church that loves the kids, loves the youth. Loves the next generation, Father, because that's the future. And Lord, thank you that they have a voice here. Thank you that they have a task, a job here, a service. We all do. And Father, every story is so sweet because it's what you've done in our lives. And so, Lord, I just pray you take away any fear. I pray you take away any shame. I pray you just take away any hesitation if somebody wants to share this morning. And I pray they declare all the good things that you've done for them in their lives. So God, bless them now. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to turn it over to you, man.
All right. So look, while the kids, we're just going to get all the kids up here. We're going to get, yes. So look, this weekend, come on, kids, y'all come on up on stage. So look, this weekend was all about faith. Heroes of faith. So what do y'all put your faith in? I asked the same question to the kids. What do you put your faith in? Drake, do you ride a bicycle and when you're right before coming to where you need to stop, push that brake handle to stop? Right? So you're putting your faith in what? A brake, right? Parents, how many times when we have our kids in the car, hey kids, do y'all always know that your parents are going to stop at the red light in the car? No. No. You mean you don't? Whoa. So some of these parents is driving crazy, right? I don't know. But look, we have faith in a little pedal that we push that stops us right at the point before we get into other traffic's way, right? So I asked these kids, you know, we put such faith in something like that. Why don't we put more faith in our Savior and our God? Right? And hey, I'll get out of the way. And these kids, this weekend we talked about heroes of faith. Now we talked about four. We talked about Abraham. One of them will share Abraham in a minute. We talked about Noah. You know, Noah done something plumb. Well, I'll let them tell you. And then we also talked about, we talked about somebody else that you wouldn't really think, but she was, Rahab. And then we ended with the last one this morning, which, and I'll let Clay and Colton, Clay and Hudson, yeah, it's been a long weekend, tell you about that. But look, hey, that was just a few of the heroes of faith. And we told them, said, look, you know, God wants us to have that same faith and to be that hero of faith as well with them. So this weekend we had all kind of, every morning, not every morning. Look, it's like we was there many mornings. We was just there one morning. That was this morning. Woo! But look, so every time before we'd start a lesson, we would start out, yeah, it's been one of them weekends. We'd start out with a song. Yes. Yes. We're going to start. Look, we would start out with this one song. And, you know, God, here, I'm going to move it. God wants us to make every move that he makes, right? He wants us to make every move that he makes. So before every lesson, we would do this song right here. Y'all ready? Y'all ready? Let's play this video. Every move I make, I want to make it in you. Now look, if the adults want to get energized, you can stand up. The moves is up there. Turn it up a little. Because we really have fun. Yeah. Here we go. Come on. We started out with that song, and then we'd always follow up with another one right behind that. That would kind of, like, that gets them going, and that gets some of the energy out of them, because they're all energized, like the energized bunny. But then we would do a song, and we're not going to play that song. I should have played that song. It is a real good song. But I'm not going to play it. I was talking about that, but it was a real calm song. And we would tell them just to listen, and they would sit in their chairs, and they would be quiet, and they did not move. They did not even speak. Are they like at home? No. But look, they wouldn't even speak, and they looked at the words, and they listened to the music, and the words was, "I depend on you. Yes, I depend on you. He is our living water." You know, it's, "I trust in you." The song is amazing. I never heard it until this weekend. I should have put it, but I didn't. But anyway, so after the music, then we would do our lessons. And the first lesson of the week was, or of the week, here I go, it was just a day and a half. God, the first lesson, which was at like 1 o'clock, no, 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 1 o'clock, yeah, 1 o'clock, was about Abraham. So we're gonna let this young fella, he volunteered to tell us about Abraham.
Good morning. How y'all doing today? I'm here to tell you about Abraham. And I'd also like to thank Emerson for teaching us about Abraham at Kids Camp. Abraham's name was not originally Abraham. It was Abram. And his wife's name was not Sarah. It was Sarai. And Abraham, three travelers came to Abraham to his tent, and he gave them food and washed their feet, and they told him that he would have a baby, and that's when he knew that they were messengers from God. Sarah was outside of the tent, and she laughed. Abraham said, "Do you not believe that the Lord cannot do this?" Then a few years later, they had a son. They named him Isaac, which means full of laughter, which was probably because either he was super joyful, or because Sarah laughed that she would have a baby. God said to Abram. To take his son to a mountain and sacrifice him. They traveled 3 days he took two servants and a donkey, and halfway up the mountain, Abraham said, "Stop, let us go and praise our Lord. We will be back." Abraham said, which means that he had super strong faith that both of them would end up coming back. And after they got to the top, or closer to the top, Isaac asked, "Where is the lamb for the sacrifice?" Abraham says, "God will provide." When they reach the top, Abraham sets up the altar and bounds Isaac in rope and lays him on the altar. He grabs the knife, and before he killed him, an angel of the Lord appeared and said, "Do not lay a finger on the boy." And then there was a ram in the thicket, and that was caught in the thicket, and he went over there and killed the ram and laid it on the altar for a burnt sacrifice. Later on, the mountain was named God Will Provide because God provided for Abraham. Wow. The end.
Whew. Duke, now, I'm going to tell you, these kids listen. They listen to more than what you think. So be careful what you say, what you do, because they listen. And look, hey, and it was more than just faith. Look, God told Abraham to just go at the beginning. Guess what Abraham done? What did Abraham do?
He went to the mountain to sacrifice his son.
Yeah, and didn't hesitate. So that was the first lesson. And just like an hour later, which seemed like days. So we had the next lesson, and it was Noah. And Colton was going to tell us about Noah. Yeah, I can hold it. Yeah, hey, y'all come right here and get right here beside of me. Come here, Dallas. Get beside me. There you go. Y'all stand right there. All right, so we talked about Noah the next day. Now hold it up there where they can hear you. There you go. Now we talked about Noah. Now tell them about Noah.
Back then, they never seen rain, so they thought Noah was pretty crazy.
They did.
Everybody thought that. I don't know why. But you would wonder, how did the plants get water?
How did they?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I forgot.
What's on the ground when you walk out in the mornings?
Dew.
Yeah, go ahead though, son. You're doing good.
I can't remember the rest. I forgot.
Oh, you forgot. Well, Noah built the ark, and he told him how big. A guy told Noah to build the ark. Right? How big?
I don't know.
You don't know? You want me to help you?
Yeah.
You want me to help you? All right. Okay, so me and Colton's going to tell this story. Now, I don't know if I can talk like Colton. All right, so I'm going to tell it, and then you repeat it, okay? So Noah, so God told Noah to build an ark.
God told Noah to build an ark.
And Noah's, and Noah didn't question him.
Noah didn't question him.
And then the people just walked around and thought, probably thought that Noah was
crazy.
And God told Noah exactly how to build it. He built it out of what kind of wood?
Gopher.
Gopher wood. That's right. And he said, now look, he said, make this boat. I don't forgot how many cubic feet long, how many cubic feet wide, and how many cubic feet tall. But it was 450 foot long. It was 70 foot
wide,
and it was 45 foot
tall.
I believe that's right. Now I could be wrong, but I think that's right. But it was big, and it just didn't have but one level. But it had how many?
Three,
that's right. And while he was building it, he said, Noah, he said, I want you to take pitch and put it on the inside and outside of the boat. So God told Noah to
put pitch on the boat because it would make it float.
Put pitch on the boat because it would make it float. And he told him to put the door in the
inside the boat.
Yeah. And then he said, so look, I'm going to tell you, said now, it was like a 7-day pitch. I don't know exactly the time, but he said, when it come time for the rain, God told Noah to load the boat.
Two animals, a peach.
And that was going to take how many? What kind of animals were they going to take?
Snakes, any kind of animal.
Two of?
Any kind of animal.
Two of?
Male and female.
Yeah, male and female. Two of every kind. Yeah, male and female. And God said, Noah, take some extra animals so that you can eat and provide food or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. Is that what he said? Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So they was on the boat for how many days? And now it started to rain. It rained how many days?
40 days. 40 nights.
Yeah. And then the rain stopped. And then while the rain stood, now it rained taller than any mountain.
20 foot above any mountain.
So it was water everywhere. For
150 days.
Yeah, and it was, and look, could you imagine? Now, it said that God, now why did God do this? Because man had gotten what?
Believed in him.
Evil.
Corrupt. Full of sin. Did nothing right, did everything wrong.
Yeah. So see, I'm Geminizing. He's doing some Geminizing. But it's from the Bible. But look, so Noah flooded the earth and it stayed on the earth for 150 days. And then the water started subsiding, right? And then what did he send out of the window first?
Raven.
Say a raven.
Raven.
A raven, that's right. He sent a raven out, and then it wasn't long. He sent a raven out once or twice, and then he said, okay, I'm going to send a dove. And he sent a dove. Now, the dove come back with something the first time?
No.
No. Second time, what did he come back with?
Peach.
No, not a peach.
An olive branch.
Olive branch. That's right. That's right. And that meant that the ground was starting to dry up, right? So I think he then waited several more days later. And then God told Noah to what?
Unload out a boat.
Yeah.
And take the animals out. And multiply. And Noah had faith.
Yeah. Yeah. Is that, you good?
Yeah.
All right. So. we have fun. I'm going to tell you, if you ever want to go and feel young and youthful again, just go with us. We have fun. We really do. Now, the second day, the third lesson was about Rahab, okay? And Sweet Sadie is going to tell the story of Rahab. Now, Rahab was a little different from the others because the first two were of Israelites. Rahab wasn't. You know, and actually, let's just see what Sadie tells you about Rahab. You want me to hold it for you? You got it.
Okay.
You got it. Hold it up there.
Rahab was a girl. The other two were boys that we learned about. And Rahab had faith that the spies were from God. So she hid the spies. And then she asked the spies if they could help by keeping her family, and they said yes. So, and they told her to put a red ribbon out the window, and she did, as they said.
So Rahab let the men out of the window with the scarlet robe.
I do that.
Okay, all right. So, but Rahab, look, she was not an Israelite, but she had faith because she knew that the spies that come over were Israelites. And the Israelites and the Rahab was, they was in the city of what was the city?
Starts with a J.
Jericho.
That's right. And they were scared because they had already knew what God, Israelites' God, had done at the Red Sea. What did he do at the Red Sea?
Split the water.
That's right. And it had them melted in fear. They were scared because they knew what the Israelites' God could do. And they were so afraid. But the spies come into town and they came to Rahab, and Rahab hit them. She hit them on, where did she hide them at?
In her house.
On top of the
roof.
That's right. Under some flax, right? And some flax leaves or something like that. Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. And then after the spies left, what did she tell them?
If they could spare her and her family.
Yes. And they said, you just keep your family, and what you do is you put a scarlet rope out your window so that they would know when no harm would come on them, right? That's right. And that's what she did. But you know what is so miraculous? Rahab had such faith, God used her. Have you ever thought about Rahab's lineage? Have you? Have you thought about Rahab's lineage? Jesus is from the line of Rahab. Just because she was not one of God's chosen, but she had the faith and she became God's chosen. If we have that same faith, we can become God's chosen and be used mightily just like Rahab. So. Look, did she not do a good job? Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, Jacob.
All right. So, now, hey, Jacob, come here. Come here, Jacob. All right. So look, when Jacob was doing his story, he done something. And the kids, he said, every time that we do this, I want you to imitate me. Okay? You remember what it was? All right. I'm going to hold it, and I'll hold the mic for you. And y'all ready? Y'all ready? Y'all know? All right, here we go. Ready.
So it's God rescues those who trust in him. God rescues those who trust in him.
Yeah, so we've done that a lot. And during the story, he said, now look, every time I would mention spy, they would be like, because, you know, spies use binoculars, whatever, spy. But anyway, they had a good time with that. They had a good time. So that was that day, and it was a full day. I'm about hoarse from it, but it was fun. The kids loved it. They had a blast. So this morning was the last lesson. Now, it's a person of faith, but it wasn't one of the ones in Hebrews, but it was a person that had huge faith in his father, that done what his father wanted, and it was about Jesus. We talked to the kids this morning, you know, lasting life is free to us through faith. You've got to have that faith. And so the lesson this morning was about faith and about a woman that had faith that she, whatever God spoke, would be so. And so I'm going to let these two young fellas here, they wanted to team up to do it. But anyway, will that pick them up? Okay, I'm going to get out of the way.
So we have these two cups, and it says new heart and old heart. That looks like the old heart. This is the new heart.
The old heart is before you get saved is what you have. New heart is what you have after you get saved. And the old heart has holes in it that lets all your love and peace out.
And then if you have this new heart, it gains up all the love and it spreads it out to more and more people. Then they can just tell more people about it.
Who shared that with you?
Gracie shared this with us that we need to, about the new heart and the old heart, that we need to, that some love falls out of the old heart, but then the new heart, it keeps it all up and just spreads it more to more people.
Jesus, we depend on you. Jesus, you are our hero of faith, for our working breath, for our waking breath, for our daily bread, for the sun to rise, for our sleep at night. Jesus, you're the way, the truth, and the life. You're the well that never runs dry. We are the branch, and Jesus, you are the vine. Draw us close and teach us to abide. Where the Spirit leads as we are following, for the victories still in front of us. When we pass through death, as we enter rest, for eternal life to be raised with Christ, we depend on you. We depend on you. Here we are, Lord. Would you teach us to abide?
Teach us, Jesus, to all abide in you. Jesus, teach us all how to love like you. Jesus, teach us how to know to be your personal Lord and Savior so we can go to heaven. Thank you, Jesus, for all the miracles that you are performing and still are performing. Thank you, Jesus, for walking that road to Calvary so everyone here can go to heaven. Jesus, thank you for Gracie, Emerson, and Jacob for coming and speaking your truth straight out of the Bible this week here. Last, Jesus, thank you for all the adults that gave their time to spend with us this weekend. Mr. Jim, Miss Dana, Mr. Nathan, Jessica, Miss Jessica, Miss Robin, Miss Nicole, Miss Norma, and Allison. Thank you all for supporting our children's ministry at Mercer Baptist Church.
All right. So look, the gospel message was there, and you heard it. Through faith, we can have everlasting life with our Savior. But it's only through faith, and it's not simple. It's not easy. It's a struggle daily. So we got to just keep a hold of that faith and continually trust in Jesus. Continually trust in Jesus. I had fun. I tell you, I did. I know the kids, that the gospel's presented, and we told them, you know, if one of these kids come up to you and they won't tell them about Jesus if they ask you, because it's our responsibility. We've got to love and show the love of Christ to these children. The world won't do it. I can't preach that enough. The world wants to devour, destroy, and tear them apart. So it's up to us, church. So that was our weekend in a nutshell. But now, the adults don't know this. The kids don't know this. But you know what? We'd always end with a song. And I loved it. I love it. I love it. And look, it was a serious weekend, really. It was about faith. It was about, yes, Miss Norma, don't go nowhere. It was about faith, and we had fun. And I really, truly believe that what we've done this weekend will have an impact on these kids' lives. I really believe that. So I pray that you pray daily that what they heard this weekend will continue to embed in them, okay? So, you know, I'm going to, if I close in prayer and then just end with a song and dismiss. Is that good? Yes. What, dear? Oh. Let's close in prayer. Look, we're going to close in prayer. I'm going to close this. And then after that, we're going to let the songs end like we end. Like the kid, because they love it. They love it. You know, it's all about having fun and bringing joy and happiness to life. People say, being a Christian is no fun. Boo-hoo.
Christians don't, the people that's they don't know what they're missing. It's more fun being a Christian than being a person that's lost out in this world, because actually, if you're lost, you're just having your joy right now. My joy is going to last forever. Amen. Woo, let's close in prayer. Let's close in prayer. Father, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Thank you for these kids. I pray your blessings over them. I pray, God, that what we taught and Lord, the breath that you give us adults to work with these kids this weekend, I pray that it doesn't go in vain, that God, that what we did this weekend will change their lives. Maybe not now. God, sometimes the seed's planted, but we just got to water it, trusting and having faith that, Lord, that seed will sprout into something amazing, and that's a child of you, Father. So I pray for these kids, and I pray for their future. I pray for their lives. I pray for their salvation. I pray if there's one here today, Father, amongst this crowd, any of these adults, any of these other kids, I pray that if they do not know you as their personal Lord Savior, God, that they would not spend another day without confessing you. Lord, I pray for the lost. God, you know many are hurting, many are sick. We just pray your touch, your healing power, Father, only your power, Father. Just thank you for the adults that worked this weekend, for the youth. Lord, thank you for the parents that just shared their children and trusted us with their kids. Lord, I pray your blessings over them and their homes. For those that didn't get to come because of sickness, God, thank you for them. Thank you for all that you do. Most of all, we thank you for Jesus. And it's his name I pray. Amen. So we're going to close. We're going to close in this one song, okay? And then after this song, you're dismissed, okay? You're dismissed. But this is what we would end every day in. And I'm going to tell you, if you want some aerobics, if you want some aerobics, some exercise, come hang out with the kids. Go ahead.
Sound doctrine, dispersed in the comments. that weak sermons, leaving the weak hurt. No one's changed by Sunday service. We need discernment, check what you be affirming, cause the church can be full of members but empty in conversion. Preach the gospel and stand back, look.